About the federal judge who recently approved AT&T's purchase of Time Warner for $85.4 billion. Before the ink was dry on the judge's decision, Comcast made an all-cash $65 billion offer to purchase 21st Century Fox, but Fox already had an offer from Disney. Now, Disney expected to increase their $55 billion stock offer with a little bit of cash added. How will the bottom lines of these companies be impacted? What might it mean for consumers and shareholders? Here to help us through it all is the founder and CEO of the Stock Swoosh, the always insightful and ever delightful Melissa Armo. Melissa, thank you again for being with us. When we look at what AT&T and Time Warner currently own, it's pretty incredible. I mean, with AT&T, there's DirecTV, Singular Wireless, all the phone companies like Bell South, Southwestern Bell, and Ameritech, among many others that I can't recall. And with Time Warner, there's that flagship Time magazine, of course, Warner Communications, the music and the cable that goes with it, and then Turner Broadcasting, think CNN, plus the old school America Online. I'm not sure how much value is there. So, Melissa, what's going on with the companies and their stocks, and what would a new merged company look like from a bottom line perspective?
Well, the media landscape is definitely changing. It's interesting because you had, like you said, these phone companies like AT&T, these telecommunication companies, now all of a sudden they're into content. The real money, the big, big money everyone's seen on the writing on the wall is for content. It's creating content and it's controlling the content and then charging to view the content. And so all of these companies are trying to compete with the likes of Netflix, which is controlling the content as far as creating it and then airing it for people at a very cheap price, because if you sign up for Netflix, you can pay 15, 20 bucks a month and then watch brand new shows. So the writing's on the wall where these companies are feeling the pressure that they have to get in. AT&T stock right now is down. And Time Warner looks great since this deal broke. And since the news came out, that stock has really gotten a lift. But AT&T stock is down. Obviously, this is going to cost an enormous amount of money for this takeover. But it's really changing the media landscape. And look for fewer and fewer companies in the future, as you had discussed about Fox and all the bids that are out for that, because probably Disney is going to put another bid out against Comcast. I don't think Disney's necessarily going to let this go.
Well, let's talk about that a little bit. I mean, so both Disney and Comcast are sort of pining for 21st Century Fox. Why would Fox be such a good get?
Fox is a great get, and it's a good question, and here's why. Because of the studios, because of creating the content, because of 21st Century Fox, the movies that they've created, the studios in California, there's huge money in that. So they want to own those studios to be able to create even more content, and they want to get bigger and bigger and bigger. And I got to be honest with you, I think Disney and Fox is a good partnership. You think about The Simpsons, that's on Fox. Disney would own The Simpsons franchise then. I mean, it just seems like a perfect fit. But Comcast wants a piece of it. They put in an enormous bid over the price of what Disney was offering, and we haven't heard from Disney yet. This just happened last week. Any day now, we could hear something back from Disney. I don't think it's going to stand where it's at right now. This Fox stock right now today hit up over FOXA, F-O-X-A is the stock symbol. It hit up over $45 a share. This could go to $50 a share before all is said and done, or even over that, till everything is shaken out here.
Yeah, it's pretty incredible. I think the folks were throwing it up on the screen, looking at that number going up and up. It's pretty amazing. Okay, let's talk about Disney as a standalone, Melissa. As theme parks go, ticket prices are over 20% what they were 5 years ago. And that's about $100 on average per day, $120 during the holidays and peak times. And Disney just announced that this Friday, a day before the new Pixar Pier attraction opens at the California location, for a mere $299. You can get a sneak peek a day before. Plus, that incredible two movies just came out last weekend, and I guess you can tell who has a little one around the house. And it opened at number one, making $180 million over the weekend. But in the aggregate, Melissa, how is Disney doing?
Disney stock is doing great. Again, they got a lift from the news. that when it came through, initially when they bid for Fox, the stock got a lift, and even the stock looks great now. It's in an uptrend. It's not that far off the highs. Disney has really been capitalizing on this idea of creating new creatures, new movies, new content, new things to interest people. Disney has always done a great job with that, with creativity. Now they want to expand. They're going to own more of Hulu. They're going to own, I think, 60% of Hulu if this Fox sub bid goes through, which is a big deal, because you can watch content through Hulu, but also Disney is pulling all of their programming for you to watch off of Netflix by the end of this year, so that's a big deal, too. Disney sees, again, the writing on the wall for viewing shows, not only through television and movies, but also in the internet, and Disney wants to control more of that, charging for it to view it on their programming, and that's why it is a good deal to buy Fox, and they can, again, have the studios and be able to create even more movies and pictures, and that's where all the money is, so they can charge those prices to get into and express more interest, and to get into the parks, and they have the characters, they have the parades with the characters, they make all the theme park and the rides with the characters. That's what Disney does really well. So people pay for it.
Yeah, following the money. I want to look at Comcast, how they're doing. How's their stock doing?
That stock is down, too. It's very interesting. The stocks that are trying to take over these companies, with the exception of Disney, are down. So AT&T, which is taking over Time Warner, stock is down, stock at a downtrend. Time Warner's up. You have Comcast, that stock is down. Stock is at a downtrend since they put the bid in. It's still down compared to Disney. Disney is the only stock that put a bid in for another one of these multi-mega-million companies that is up. Up in the chart, up in the price since all this news came out. Disney looks great. Disney's a buy. Expect Disney to come back with something to compete against Comcast for that bid. But I'll tell you one quick thing, Bart, before we go. All of this is going to mean less and less companies in the future, and the companies are going to get bigger and fatter and bigger. But as a consumer, don't necessarily think that you're going to get to pay less. It's going to be where the fact is you have two or three big, huge megalodon companies, and they may be trying to price gouge people or control the content. So from a consumer's perspective, I don't think that this is necessarily a good idea. And from a media landscape perspective, you have less people putting less ideas out there, so I don't think it's really great. It's great if you happen to own Fox and the stock is getting the pop. It's great if you own stock in Disney. Those are great buys. But as far as overall for consumer, or even if you're in the television industry, I don't think this is necessarily going to be great. But the landscape is changing, and nobody can do anything to change it. It's going to happen. It's setting up. Everybody is worried and scared of Netflix.
Like I said, always insightful and delightful. Melissa Armo, thanks for your time, Melissa.
Thanks for having me.